Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Atika Shazwani Mitiraza and my matrix number is 1202016. Today, I would like to present about Muslim scholar named Muhammad Al-Fazari. Okay, now firstly, let's take a look at his background to get to know him better. His full name is Muhammad Ibn Ibrahim Ibn Habib Ibn Sulaiman Ibn Samra Ibn Jundab Al-Fazari. He was born in Kufa, Iraq in the year 765 Masihi. There were difference of opinion as to the date of his death. Some say that he died at 796 and some others say he died at 806. Muhammad Al-Fazari was a Persian philosopher, mathematician and astronomer. He has a father named Ibrahim Al-Fazari who was also an astronomer and mathematician. People often confused between him and his father because their names look alike. Okay, next, let's talk about his life history.
Muhammad Ibn Ibrahim Al-Fazari was from an old family in Kufa, which is now known as Al-Najaf in the modern Iraq. He worked on astronomy and astrology, particularly on the composition of astronomical handbooks with tables for computing the celestial positions. And this was done in the court of Al-Mansur in the later times of the Abbasid Caliphate. In the year of 762, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim Al-Fazari has helped in supervising the casting of the horoscope that has selected the auspicious date for the founding of Baghdad. Then, in the early year of 770s, he has collaborated with his father, which is Ibrahim Al-Fazari, and Yaqub ibn Tariq in the translation of Sanskrit astronomical texts, and this was brought to Baghdad by an Indian astronomer, and the text was written by Brahmagupta. According to several biographers, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim Al-Fazari was a pioneer and he is positively unrivaled in his mastery of astral sciences.
Ibrahim Al-Fazari also has published several books related to the science and astronomy. Firstly, Kitab Az-Zij al-Sin lil-Arab, which this book told about the astronomical tables according to the years of the Arabs. Secondly, Kitab Al-Qasidah fi ilmi al-Nujum. This book told about the poem on signs of the stars. Thirdly, Measurement of Noon has been written a lot in Kitab Al-Miqyas Lisiwal by Ibrahim Al-Fazari. Fourthly, Kitab Al-Amal Bil-Astrolab wa Huwa Dot Al-Halaq, which is it discusses about the use of the armillary sphere. And lastly, is Kitab Al-Amal Bil-Astrolab Al-Musattah in the book told about the use of the plane astrolab.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nurliana Batrisha binti Suhaimi. My matrix number is 1202036. So now I would like to share about the contribution of Ibrahim Al-Fazari Al-Munajjam, the Muslim scholar of astronomy. So first of all, he translated the Indian astronomical text by Brahmagupta, which is at 7th century after that, into Arabic as the book of Az-Zij al-Sin al-Arab or Kitab al-Zij al-Sin al-Arab or the book of Sindit. So, book translation of Al-Fazari has been copied partially into Latin in the Middle Age of Trajan de Luna Hipparchusis. Latin translation books have been used by European universities to teach astronomy. So here is a picture of or diagram of the book of Sindit. First invention in the age of Islamic technology is astrolab. So what is an astrolab? In Islamic worldview, it was the first analog counting machine functioned as an astronomical aid to calculate the time of sunrise and sunset, the position points of the sun and stars and other celestial objects at a given time. So this is a pic. So as a Muslim, let's appreciate Al-Fazari's contribution by take advantages of this technology to improve our knowledge about Islam and astronomy. Wallahu a'lam.